Welcome to the world. The sculpture on which this ecological survey takes place functions as a life support system, a biome for the plants, animals, microbes, and fungi that live within its boundaries. The sculpture exists isolated from familiar natural cycles, which have to be simulated by the team. This is the team. The team's job is an arduous task. They monitor the sculpture around the clock to ensure it is meeting all the requirements necessary to support life. The team is responsible for creating the sculpture, providing the necessities for life to flourish on it, and cataloging the organisms that populate it. The first animal discovered on the sculpture was some type of centipede that was found on the second large crack along the main landmass. That discovery was followed by another, after the team observed a spider living on the cliffs of that same region. The region was dubbed a rift valley, a reference the team was making to where their own species was first discovered to live. Now, weeks into the survey of this sculpture, we see many different species inhabiting it. The biodiversity that exists on this sculpture is more diverse than that of any other sculpture in the world. This gecko can grow to an unusually large size on the sculpture, as it has no natural predators in the region. These geckos prefer to live on the more desolate parts of the sculpture, and their rough skin is an evolved characteristic to shield them from the rocky terrain. These geckos will shed their skin once a month, and then eat it, a behavior little understood by the team. Their current theory is that the geckos are doing this to hide the evidence that a gecko was ever there. Across the sculpture we see a different vista, where some rodents have made themselves right at home on the first segment of the main landmass. These mice are very common on the sculpture, and have been found to live on every region of it. They are highly adaptable, which allows them to live anywhere. In this case, that's on the fertile forest floor. Here they are omnivores, foraging on the ground for new seedlings that can provide them with sustenance, and sifting the dirt as well as they hunt tiny insects. In other environments, mice can become increasingly aggressive towards each other, but on the sculpture, they have better relations because of the abundance of food. One abundance may lead to another, however, and the sculpture has another inhabitant that keeps the mice's numbers in check. The mice are unaware of the threat. It's a rat snake, and it's enormous. It makes the sculpture seem small as it easily stretches across it, moving freely from one outcrop to another. Its tongue flickers in and out as it gets a feel of its surroundings. With its heightened sense of smell and limited eyesight, it can smell that the mice are nearby before it can see them. But the mice are catching on now as well. They can sense the snake as it approaches. The snake makes great strides across the different regions, effortlessly meandering towards its prey. Meanwhile, the mice are afraid to leave the sculpture, as it is all they know of the world. Their speed and agility will benefit them now, though, as the snake is a much slower predator. The rat snake hunts, relying largely on the element of surprise, a cover it has already blown. The mice only have one option, and that is to try to outrun it. And to get to the other side of the sculpture, where they can take refuge. And they seem to have done it. They dart down the path onto the far side of the sculpture, and are safe. At least, for the time being. Away from the mainland, the outcrops on the sculpture are places of rare and unique life forms. Outcrop 5 is the only site on the sculpture where copper pines grow. These trees are the only coniferous plants on the sculpture, and at their roots, they support an even stranger creature. Brown mites are endemic to this outcrop, and can't be found anywhere else. But more surprisingly, is that they live not directly on the sculpture, but on top of a middleman of sorts. A hissing cockroach. Operating as an ecosystem in a similar way that this sculpture does, the cockroach is a home for these mites, which survive by eating fungus off of its carapace. These parasites are harmless to their host. As the roach moves, it uses its antennas to scan the air, in a way much like the rat snake does with its tongue. The roach is using these receptors to learn about different environmental conditions around it. Or possibly, the roach just uses them now to wave us goodbye, as our time on the sculpture is ending. We've encountered an unfathomable wealth of biodiversity here today. The team will continue recording data as they attempt to better understand this bizarre intersection of natural and artificial environments, on top of this small sculpture, in this expansive, mysterious world.